Roberta Marx is a local artist. She lived down here in the Keys since 1981, so she's been a long-term artist down here. This is a retrospective. She's worked in many different mediums, including pottery, paintings, mixed media, and construction. So this exhibit really brings together a lot of elements that she's worked in. There definitely are elements from her early career in here all the way through works that have just been created specifically for this show. So you can see works that she's created in the 1970s all the way up through now. So you can see her progression of works, what her influences are, and actually the materials with which she was working with. Roberta actually has her master's in fine art, so she's studied, or she hasn't picked it up recreationally or learned it through small classes here in town. So to have that caliber of artists in town, that definitely reflects in the way that the exhibit, the material that's in the exhibit, and the way that it's laid out. So it's definitely not what people expect when they come into the museum from a local Key West artist. Roberta has incorporated a lot of different elements into her artwork. A lot of them are found objects, whether it be things found locally that people are discarding, things that she finds on walks. She's also picked up a lot of pieces on her travels. She's been around the world, so a lot of her pieces incorporate elements from those countries and give her a reflection on where she's been. And what she does is assemble them together with other objects that either she's created or for assemblies, for instance, she puts them into boxes or containers to really exemplify the message she's trying to get across. I think the tone of the show is something that people are not necessarily expecting when they walk in. People expect bright colors, blues and purples and pinks, and you walk in here and you really have that a darker tone. She incorporates a lot of grays, a lot of blacks, a lot of whites, keeps to a very neutral palette, and I think that's reflective of what she is exemplifying in her artwork and the place that she's reaching inside to bring out in her artwork. There's definitely a few pieces in here that stand out more than others. For instance, there's a piece called Retro One, and that actually has Charlie Hebdo, the French satirical newspaper. She actually collected quite a few of their issues, and what it is a really a nice piece that honors those folks who died at the hands of people that were unhappy with the material that Charlie Hebdo was putting out there. So that's definitely a standout piece for me in the exhibit. So in the exhibit, there are a few placards next to pieces of the artwork. The text that's on them came directly from the artist. It sort of describes either where she acquired the material or where she made the material or where she actually made the artwork and what it means to her and the message that it's trying to convey. It's not with every piece that's in the exhibit, but with select pieces that she felt really had a deep meaning and wanted our visitors to have a better understanding of her artwork. I think the pieces that have inspired either the most questions or the most comments about have been the pieces that contain things that belong to children. That really resonates with our visitors. A lot of our visitors have children with them, and so it's something that they identify with, and it begs the question of why she incorporates that into a lot of her artwork. You know, did something happen to her as a child? Did she experience something with her own children? So we've had a lot of questions and comments from our visitors about that. We decided to put the exhibit together now because Roberta's been here and working in Key West for the last over 30 years, actually. And we thought with the quality of her work that it was time to honor her with a retrospective. We asked her what she would like to do, the direction it would like to take. This was really a collaborative effort on our part and the artist's part. And she wanted to incorporate old pieces and new to really make it very full and show the range of her skills and diversity over the last 30 and 40 years. Two things I would like the visitors to take away. One, I'd like them to understand the breadth and depth of the artistry that occurs in Key West itself. This is not your typical artwork that people associate with the island, and I think on the surface it actually shows how much Key West relies on its cultural diversity. The other thing to take away from it is the artist's work herself. She has put her heart and soul into the artwork, and I think we would love our visitors to understand the process which she goes through and the delicate nature with which she assembles a lot of her pieces.